Hello, my dear students. See, in the previous class, we have understood about the concept of the shapes of total product curve, marginal product curve, average product curve, isn't it? In that, we understood that as we go on increasing the number of units of labor used, that is, as we are increasing the number of units of input used, what happened there? The total product value was increasing. Isn't it? But in case of marginal product and average product, what happened was initially the marginal product value went on increasing to a certain level of input use, that is to a certain level of number of labor used, no? Up to third unit, if you say in our example, there the marginal product value was increasing up to the third unit of labor used, isn't it? But after fourth unit of labor use, or if you observe that by the fourth unit of labor use, there the marginal product value went on decreasing, isn't it? Then moving on to the average product value, what happened to that? See, there initially as we increase the number of units of labor use, that is as we increase the input factor, what happened there? The average product value was increasing, but after reaching a certain level of input, what happened? The average product value also started decreasing, isn't it? And if you compare the marginal product value and average product value, up to certain level of labor, that is up to certain level of unit of labor used, the marginal product value was greater than the average product value, isn't it? Then after fourth unit of labor use, what happened there was the average product value was greater than the marginal product value. And looking into the shapes of this TP curve, MP curve and AP curve, what we have learned in the previous class, there you can say that the total product curve is, it is positively sloped curve, isn't it? The shape of TP curve is positively sloped curve. Then what about marginal product curve shape? See, the shape of the marginal product curve is inversely U-shaped, isn't it? The shape of marginal product curve is inversely U-shaped. Then what about the shape of the average product curve? The product, that is the shape of the average product curve, is it is also inversely U-shaped, isn't it? Then after this, you have understood about the concept of returns to scale. What do you mean by returns to scale? See, it shows the behavior of production or returns to scale, wherein you are increasing all the input factors of production simultaneously in the same ratio. Okay, so there you come across the different three types of returns to scale. One was constant returns to scale. Here what happened was, when you are increasing the factors of input simultaneously, then there was a increase in the output in the same ratio, isn't it? That is known as what? Constant returns to scale. Even we have come across one of the example, isn't it? That is, if you increase the 50% of input used in the production, then what happens there? Then the even the output will be increased to 50% of value. Okay, then after that we have understood about increasing returns to scale. What do you mean by this increasing returns to scale? See, here when you are increasing the input factors simultaneously, then you can observe the increase in the output more than that of the value. Means there is a increase in the output produced. Okay, suppose if you are increasing 50% of the input used, then the output produced will be how much? It might be 60% or 70%, like that. Means there is a increase in the returns, or there is an increase in the productivity, or there is a increase in the output value. Okay. Then what happened was like other thing, that is decreasing returns to scale. What do you mean by this decreasing? Decreasing means what? The output value was decreasing there. So here what happened was like when a proportional increase in all the input results in the increase in the output by a smaller proportion. See here, when you are increasing the input factor simultaneously, then there you have observed that there is a increase in the output but by a lesser proportion. Suppose if you are increasing the 50% of input of factors, means you can observe 30% or 40% of output. Okay, that is about returns to scale. Then today we shall start with the other topic, that is cost. Okay. Cost. What do you mean by cost? In the starting of this chapter itself, we have come across this topic or concept. What do you mean by cost? See, cost means what? Expense, isn't it? See, here we come across another word like cost of production. What is that? Cost of production. What do you mean by this cost of production means? See, it is the expense what a company, an organization, or an organization will bear in order to produce a commodity or a product or in order to render a service. That is known as what? Cost of production. What do you mean by cost of production? It means the expenses incurred by a firm in order to produce a commodity. That is known as what? Cost of production. Okay. And we know that in order to produce output, a company will be using the different combinations of input factors. The different combinations of input, isn't it? So there, for example, if you want to produce 50 units of output, 50 units of output na produce maadbeku anta ankoli aitha, ili erad input factors na tagolona, ondu labor, inondu capital. Labor and another one is what? Capital. Okay. So we are having a different combinations of input which give rise to 50 units of output. Okay. Suppose L is equal to 6 and K is equal to 3, it will also give 50 units of output. Again, when L is equal to 4 unit and K is equal to 4 unit, this combination also give rise to 50 units of output. Okay. Then when L is equal to 3 unit, L is equal to 3 unit and even K is equal to 3 unit, that also will give rise to what? 50 units of output. Suppose the two input factors are considered here to produce a 50 units of output. With the different combinations, you can obtain 50 units of output. Okay. Hagadre, yav combination na company use madutte 50 units of output kodlikke anoda question. Alli namige cost of production concept important do athwa cost concept il important. Yakappa andre ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವ ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್ ಚೂಸ್ ಮಾಡತ್ತೆ ಕಂಪನಿ ಅಂದರೆ ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆನ್ಸಿವ್. ಓಕೆ, ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ಯಾವುದು ನಮಗೆ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಖರ್ಚು ಬರುತ್ತೋ ಅಥವಾ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೋ ಆ ಒಂದು ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ನ ನಾವು ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋಬೇಕು ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ನ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳುತ್ತೀವಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಸಿ ಹಿಯರ್ ಯು ಮೇ ಯೂಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ಆರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ಆರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ಟು ಒಪ್ನಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್. Among these three combination, you will be choosing one combinations of input factor which is having a what? Less expense, or which is having a least expense. Okay, so that kind of combination you can choose. that kind of combinations of input factors all the companies or all the organizations will be using, okay, because they want to reduce their expense but they want to increase their profit, isn't it? That's why. So here always the company chooses a least expensive combinations of factor inputs to produce the output, alva. So for every level of output the firm chooses the least best input combination. What does the company choose always? It chooses least best input combination. Okay, one more thing you are try to understand here. If I am selecting a least best input combination means it should be of good quality also, okay? So quality kadme ide appa kadme kharchi agutte anta adun select madala yavde company agli, because they want to produce a good quality oriented products, because nowadays consumers are giving importance for a good quality oriented products, durable products, okay, along with the price. They want based on the price, okay, they know that based on the price they can purchase any kind of product, but with a reasonable rate they want to purchase a durable and a good quality product. So a company will be choosing your what? Least best. Best means what? Your very good quality combination also you'll be choosing to produce the certain amount of output, okay. So then how do you define this cost function then? Hagadre cost function yav riti describe martivi athwa define martivi, how do you define this? Cost function. See, cost function describes the least cost of producing each level of output at given prices of factors of production and technology, okay. How do you define this cost of production? Cost of production, sorry, cost function, not cost of production. Already we have understood that cost of production, so now we shall know about cost of function. How do you define this means? It describes the least cost, okay. It describes the least cost of producing each level of output, least cost of producing each level of output at given prices of factors, at given prices of factors of production and technology. That is known as what? Cost function. See, cost function defines or it describes the least cost of producing each level of output, okay. So now ili pratiyondu unit of output nu produce madbekadre adu less expensive agirbeku, least cost agirbeku, kadame kharchu hondirbeku, jothege yav riti andre at a given prices of factors of production, okay. So yavde input factors tagoli kuda ಅದು ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಲ್ವ ಅದು ಕಡಿಮೆ ಖರ್ಚಿರಬೇಕು ಅಂದರೆ ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆನ್ಸಿವ್ ಆಗಿರಬೇಕು ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಬೈ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಅ ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿ ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಯು ಅಡಾಪ್ಟ್ ದ ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿ ಆರ್ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಮೈಟ್ ಬಿ ದ ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆನ್ಸಿವ್ ಸೊ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ and by adopting the technology, a firm should produce a good. Okay, so this is known as what? Cost function. Then here we come across one of the production function, that is Cobb-Douglas production function. So let me write that Cobb-Douglas production function, which will be important for 1 marks in the exam. They will ask you to mention or write the Cobb-Douglas production function. Okay. Cobb-Douglas production function. Cobb-Douglas production function. They may ask you to write the Cobb-Douglas production function. How you can write this means it can be represented as Q is equal to x1 to the power of alpha into x2 to the power of beta. Okay, how do you write this Cobb-Douglas production function? It can be represented as Q is equal to x1 to the power of alpha into, dot represents what? Into. There is a multiplication relationship between x1 to the power of alpha and x2 to the power of beta. So x1 to the power of alpha into x2 to the power of beta. Then let us know about this, that is what is q, what is alpha, what is beta, what is x1, what is x2, like that. Okay, so here alpha and beta are constants, they are the constant values. Okay, they are constants. Constants. Okay, then what is Q? Q is a quantity of output that can be produced. Alva, Q anili. Q is the quantity of output that is produced. Then what is this x1 and x2? See, q quantity of output can be produced by using x1 amount of first factor and x2 amount of second factor. Okay, so you can write here q amount of output, Q amount of output can be obtained, or we can say can be produced, okay, by using what? By using x1 amount of factor 1, by using x1 amount of factor 1, and x2 amount of factor 2, 200 second factor, okay. So and x2 amount of factor 2. Okay, understood? See, Cobb-Douglas production function can be represented in this manner, that is q is equal to x1 to the power of alpha into x2 to the power of beta. Okay, what are these? Alpha and beta are constants. Okay, Q means what? It is a quantity of output that can be produced by using x1 quantity of first factor. First factor yeshtu use martidira andre x1 factor, x1 amount of factor, first factor na neevu x1 quantity choose martta idira. Okay, and by using x2 amount of second factor. Okay, so this is about Cobb-Douglas production function, which can be represented as q is equal to x1 to the power of alpha into x2 to the power of beta. Okay, understood? Okay, then we shall move on to the other topic, that is short run cost. Okay, short run cost, because we will be knowing about different expenses what you will be incurring during short run here. Okay, see, this question or this topic is very important because it might be asked for 6 marks in this manner, that is, explain the various short run cost with the help of a table. ಏನಂತ ಕೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ನು ಅಂದರೆ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮಲ್ಲಿ, ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ರನ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ಟೇಬಲ್. ಅಂದರೆ ಒಂದು ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಸಮೇತ ನಾವು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ದೇರ್ ಯಾರ್ ಟು ರೈಟ್ ದ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಅಲಾಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ಅ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫಾಲೋಡ್ ಬೈ ಒನ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್. ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಒನ್ ಟೇಬಲ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಡ್ರಾ, ವೇರ್ ಇನ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಯರ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ let us know about the meaning of short run. Okay, what do you mean by short run? In the earlier classes you have come across this concept. What is meant by short run? See, in short run, some of the input factors cannot be varied, so they remain fixed. Only few factors are variable there, isn't it? See, some of the factors of input or input factors cannot be varied, they remain fixed. So you will have your sum as fixed factors or and another one as variable factors. Okay, so first let us know what do you mean by fixed cost or total fixed cost. Okay, so what is this total fixed cost means? See, total fixed cost means the cost that a firm incurs to employ these fixed inputs is known as total fixed cost. Okay, see, in short run what happens, we have few input factors as fixed and few are variable. So one variable factor you might be having. So the cost or the expenses what a company will incur, okay, incur to employ the fixed input. ಯಾವ ದಟ್ ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೋ ಅದನ್ನು ಬೇರ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಅಥವಾ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ತಕ್ಕಂಗೆ ಖರ್ಚು ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಏನು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆನ್ಸ್ನ ಬೇರ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೋ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವೇನಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ, ಟೋಟಲ್ ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ಡ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್, ವಿಚ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಅಬ್ರಿವೇಟೆಡ್ ಆಸ್ ವಾಟ್, ಟಿ ಎಫ್ ಸಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ನಾವು ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ದ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಇಯರ್ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ಡ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟಿ ಎಫ್ ಸಿ ರೆಫರ್ಸ್ ಟು? ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ total fixed cost. Okay, total fixed cost. So how do you write this? Total fixed cost means the cost that a firm bears, you can write, isn't that a firm incurs to employ fixed inputs is known as what? Total fixed cost. ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತ? ಟೋಟಲ್ ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ಡ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನಂತ ಹೇಳ್ಬೋದು ನಾವಿಲ್ಲಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ಯಾವುದಕ್ಕೆ ಖರ್ಚಿನ ಅಥವಾ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆನ್ಸ್ನ ಬೇರ್ ಮಾಡತ್ತೆ ಕಂಪನಿ, ಯಾವ್ದನ್ನ ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ, ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂತಿರತ್ತಲ್ವಾ, ಅದನ್ನ ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ಏನು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆನ್ಸ್ನ ಬೇರ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತ ಕಂಪನಿ, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವೇನಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ, ಟೋಟಲ್ ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ಡ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್. ಓಕೆ, Then what are the examples you can take here? Rent of the factory, isn't it? Then salaries of permanent employees, maintenance of building, license fee, etc. Alva, monthly wise and change agala idella salaries of permanent employees agli illa andre rent of factory adella alva. So agagi idanna navu enant karibodu illi fixed input anta tagobodu. Artha aita? Hagadre total fixed cost can be abbreviated as what? TFC. Okay, I said that in short run few factors will be fixed, so we came across TFC here, that is total fixed cost. Then some factors of input are variable in nature, they are called as variable factors, isn't it? Then how do you define this total variable cost? See, before knowing this total variable cost, one more you observe here. What is that means? Although variables are not used, means what happens there? Variable factor is zero, means the total variable cost will be zero. Okay, but the total cost value will be having some value there because you are having a some fixed expense there. Okay, so we can say that whatever the amount of output the firm produce, the fixed cost remains the same. Alva, fixed cost eniratto adu output jaasti aadanga adu kuda jaasti aagalla yakane fixed cost andre eno adu expense adu fix adu adenu next change aagalla alva. So it will not change so frequently. That is total fixed cost. And now we shall know about total variable cost. TVC means what? Total variable cost. How do you define this? See, the cost that a firm incurs to employ variable inputs, the cost or the expense what a company or organization will incur to employ the variable inputs is known as what? Total variable cost. Okay, so you can write this, the cost that a firm incurs to employ variable inputs, that is known as what? Total variable cost. Okay, ಹಾಗಾದರೆ ಈ ವೇರಿಯಬಲ್ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ನ ಏನು ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಇವೆಷ್ಟು ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಿರೋ ಆ ಒಂದು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆನ್ಸಿಗೆ ನಾವೇನನ್ನು ಕರಿತೀವಿ ಟೋಟಲ್ ವೇರಿಯಬಲ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ಅಥವಾ ವೇರಿಯಬಲ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ಬೋದು ಅಲ್ವಾ. ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಏನು ತಗೋತೀರಾ ನೀವು ವೇರಿಯಬಲ್ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ಸ್ಗೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ವೇಜ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೆಂಪರರಿ ಲೇಬರ್ಸ್ ಓಕೆ ದೆನ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಸಿಟಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆನ್ಸ್ ದೆನ್ ರಾ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಸೊ ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ವಾಟ್ variable inputs alwa. So electricity bill nodi neevu tumba electricity use madidira for a particular month anta electricity bill jaasti generate agirutte. Next second next month if you are using less amount of electricity means the bill might be less, the amount what you have to pay will be less. And the wages of laborers if you take that to temporary labors, see the temporary labors what do they get when they are working? They will be paid, isn't it? So temporary labors only when the work is more or during a certain season, during certain time they will be coming for work, isn't it? So only during that period you will be incurring the expense as a firm alva. So agadra total variable cost en agutte andre if you want to increase the output of products or the product that you want to produce, then the variable cost will be increasing. Got it? So variable cost increases when the output quantity is increasing. Okay, so output jaasti produce aagtide, output jaasti bartide andre al variable cost kuda en agiruttante jaasti agirutte. Okay, this variable cost will not remain same, it will not remain constant, it is not fixed, it keeps on changing, badlaagta irutte. Gotaita? Hagadre ಈಗ ನಮಗೆ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ಡ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ಗೊತ್ತಾಯಿತು, ಟೋಟಲ್ ವೇರಿಯಬಲ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ಗೊತ್ತಾಯಿತು. ಇದೆರಡು ಗೊತ್ತಾದರೆ ಏನು ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫೈ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು, ಏನು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು ನೀವು ಅಂದರೆ, ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಬೈ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟೂ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್. ಸೊ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ವಾಟ್, ಟಿ ಎಫ್ ಸಿ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಟಿ ವಿ ಸಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ ಟು ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ದ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ? ಟಿ ಸಿ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಟೋಟಲ್ ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಟೋಟಲ್ ವೇರಿಯಬಲ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್. ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತಾ? ಒಂದು ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ ಈಗ ಎಷ್ಟು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿದೆ, ಎಷ್ಟು ಖರ್ಚಾಗಿದೆ ಅಂತ ಡಿಟರ್ಮೈನ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂದರೆ ನಾವು ಏನು ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ? ಟೋಟಲ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಟೋಟಲ್ ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ಡ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಟೋಟಲ್ ವೇರಿಯಬಲ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್. ಟಿ ಸಿ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಟಿ ಎಫ್ ಸಿ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಟಿ ವಿ ಸಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್? ಓಕೆ, ದೆನ್ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ನೋ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಅದರ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ರನ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ರೇಜ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್. ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ರನ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ರೇಜ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್, ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ರನ್ ಆವ್ರೇಜ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್, ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಬ್ರಿವೇಟ್ ದಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಎಸ್ ಎ ಸಿ, ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ರನ್ ಆವ್ರೇಜ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ರನ್ ಆವ್ರೇಜ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್? ಸಿ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ಕರ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ದ ಫರ್ಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಿಚ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಡಿಫೈನ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ದ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ಪರ್ ಯೂನಿಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಫೈನ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ಪರ್ ಯೂನಿಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್. ದೆನ್ ಹೌ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೈಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ರನ್ ಆವ್ರೇಜ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್? ಎಸ್ ಎ ಸಿ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಟಿ ಸಿ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಕ್ಯೂ. ಓಕೆ, ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ರೇಷೋ ಆಫ್ ವಾಟ್? ಟೋಟಲ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಕ್ಯೂ. ಕ್ಯೂ ಇಸ್ ದ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್, ಟಿ ಸಿ ಇಸ್ ದ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ವಾ? ಟೋಟಲ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ಗೊತ್ತಿತ್ತು ಅಂದರೆ ನಮಗೆ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಕ್ವಾಂಟಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ನಾವು ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ರನ್ ಆವ್ರೇಜ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ನ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫೈ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು, ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು ಅಲ್ವಾ? ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಡಿಫೈನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಾ ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ರನ್ ಆವ್ರೇಜ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ಅಂದರೆ? ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಫೈನ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ದ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ಪರ್ ಯೂನಿಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಟೋಟಲ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ಪರ್ ಯೂನಿಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ರಿಟನ್ ಆಸ್ ಎಸ್ ಎ ಸಿ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಟಿ ಸಿ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಕ್ಯೂ. ಓಕೆ, then even we can calculate average variable cost. What is that? Average variable cost. How you can calculate this average variable cost? See, it is defined as a total variable cost per unit of output. Okay, what is this average variable cost? How you can determine that? So yav riti kandidithira neevu ಆವ್ರೇಜ್ ವೇರಿಯಬಲ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ವಾ? ಸೊ ಆವ್ರೇಜ್ ವೇರಿಯಬಲ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ನ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಕಂಡುಹಿಡಿಬೋದು? ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಅಬ್ರಿವೇಟೆಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಎ ವಿ ಸಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಆವ್ರೇಜ್ ವೇರಿಯಬಲ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ಬೈ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ವಿ ಸಿ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಟಿ ವಿ ಸಿ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಕ್ಯೂ. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಫೈನ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ದ ಟೋಟಲ್ ವೇರಿಯಬಲ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ಪರ್ ಯೂನಿಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಎ ವಿ ಸಿನ ನಾವು ಟಿ ವಿ ಸಿ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಕ್ಯೂ ಅಂತ ತಗೋತೀವಿ. ಆಯ್ತಾ? ಸೊ ಟಿ ವಿ ಸಿ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್? ಯರ್ ಟೋಟಲ್ ವೇರಿಯಬಲ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಕ್ಯೂ. ಕ್ಯೂ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಕ್ವಾಂಟಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್, ವಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆವ್ರೇಜ್ ವೇರಿಯಬಲ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅನದರ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆವ್ರೇಜ್ ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ಡ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಟ್? Average fixed cost. It is also very simple. Average fixed cost. Okay, how do you abbreviate that? We can write it as AFC. Average fixed cost. Average fixed cost means what? It is defined as the total fixed cost per unit of quantity or per unit of output produced. Okay, quantity of output produced. So it can be written as AFC is equal to TFC divided by Q. Okay, average fixed cost na yav riti kandidithivi andre, we can use the formula AFC is equal to TFC divided by Q. If exam has 6 marks, you have to write the meaning, then write the formula. Okay, so meaning formula vardu one problem tara one table akkond ellanu values en irutthalva aa values takkange calculate maadbeku to TC agirbodu ABC agirbodu AFC agirbodu aa riti. Okay, so average fixed cost andrenu, it is defined as the total fixed cost per unit of output, that is TFC divided by Q. Okay, then we can calculate SAC, short run average cost, very easily. Yav riti andre, by adding what? ABC plus AFC. Okay, we have another type of cost, that is short run average cost. What is that? Short run average cost. What do you mean by this? See, this can be obtained by adding average variable cost and average fixed cost. Okay, so SAC, that is short run average cost, is the sum of TFC plus TVC. Sorry, it is the sum of AVC plus AFC. Okay, short run average cost is the sum of average variable cost plus average fixed cost. Already we know the formula to find out AVC. AVC kandidiyo adu yavriti heli, TVC divided by Q alva. AFC adre TFC divided by Q. Hagadre SAC yavriti kandidithira, short run average cost andre, by adding, if you know the values of average variable cost and average fixed cost, then take a sum of this, then you can get the value of short run average cost. Okay, then we have another type of cost, that is short run marginal cost. What is that? Short run marginal cost. How to define this then? Short run average short run, not average, short run marginal cost. Short run marginal cost. How to define this? See, SMC, that is short run marginal cost, can be defined as change in total cost to the change in output. Okay, so it can be abbreviated as SMC. Okay, so how to determine this? By using, it can be determined by using the formula. What I said, that it is the ratio of change in total cost to the change in output, isn't it? Change in output alva, change in output. Agare change in total cost, change andre en symbol aktira, delta alva. Total cost andre TC use madboda. Next, change in output andre en aktira, change means delta aktira. Okay, output andre Q, isn't it? So the formula to find out short run marginal cost is delta TC divided by delta Q. Okay, short run marginal cost is equal to what? Delta TC divided by delta Q. Okay, already we know the value of total cost, take a difference of the total cost. Okay, then Q is a quantity of output produced, take a differences among the quantity of output produced, then you can find out short run marginal cost. Okay, so this is about the different types of short run cost. Okay, now we shall know how to determine the values of all these different types of cost if certain values are given, suppose TFC, TVC and the quantity of output produced is given, means then how to calculate AVC, AFC, SMC, SAC and all. Okay, so let me solve one of the problem related to that. Okay, see, this is very important. You might be given, for example, short run marginal cost and number of units of output produced, and you might be asked to determine total cost, then total variable cost. Okay, where you are knowing given the TFC value like that. Okay, so different types of problem bartha hogutte agadre illi namige output quantity of output produced kottirtare, TFC value kottidare, TVC value kuda kottidare, agare total cost ಮತ್ತೆ ಬೇರೆ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ಏನಿದೆ ಅಲ್ವಾ ಅದನ್ನ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಕಂಡುಹಿಡಿಯೋದು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಮಾಡೋಣ ಈಗ. ಓಕೆನಾ? ಓಕೆ, ಸಿ, ವಿ ಆರ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಏಟ್ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್, ದಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಎಷ್ಟು ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಂಡ್ವಿ ಅಂದರೆ 8 ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ವಾ. ಹಾಗಾದರೆ ಆ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ 8 ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ನ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಕಂಡುಹಿಡಿಯೋದು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗೋಣ. ಓಕೆನಾ? ದೆನ್ ಡ್ರಾ 9 ಕಾಲಮ್ಸ್. ಯೋ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಟೋಟಲ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್, ಕ್ವಾಂಟಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಎಷ್ಟಿದೆ ಅಂತ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿಕ್ಕೆ. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ಬರ್ತಾ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ. ಓಕೆ, totally I have drawn 9 columns in this table. Okay, column as output, that is Q. It can be abbreviated as what? Q. It is in certain units, isn't it? So output in units. Then TFC, TVC, so by using this we can get what? TC. Okay, it is in rupees. Okay, then we have in the next column as AFC, then AVC. Okay, output TFC, TVC, TC, AFC, AVC, SAC and SMC. S, AC and another one is what? Yes, MC. Yes, M, C. Okay, then write the values of Q ranging from 0 to 10. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, TFC value, I know that only one value of TFC will be given because that fixed cost is remaining same, isn't it? It's a constant value. Write here 20. Okay, then TVC value, total variable cost. Initially when there is no production the fixed cost will be there and there, so 20 ide, but variable cost 0 agirutte alva. 0, 10, 18, 24, okay, 24, 29, 33, 39, 47, 47, 60, 75, 95. Okay, assume that this is a problem. A 6 marks in short run cost explain madakkelidre neevu every type of cost na explain madandre meaning al barbittu formula barithira adadmeli table draw maadi ee rithi calculate kuda maadi tosbeku ashte ala ee rithi problem kuda barutte exams alli gothaytha it will be asked for 6 marks so ide one problem ankonre namige ile en kottidare they have given the number of output produced the number of units of output produced and they have given the values of total fixed cost isn't it and even they have given the value of total variable cost so next time again ida column andre illi total cost we know that we can determine the total cost value by using the formula what tfc plus tvc alva so iga aa formula use maadkon maartta hogana okay na so total cost is equal to what tfc plus tvc avda formula gottide ta namage hagadre total cost is equal to ili first stage alli nodi 20 plus 0 is how much 20 so for one value I am substituting here tfc is 20 tvc is 0 then you will get total cost as 20 okay likewise go on calculating the values of total cost by using this tfc and tvc 20 plus 10 30 okay 20 plus 18 38 20 plus 24 44 20 plus 29 49 okay 20 plus 33 53 20 plus 39 how much it is 59 okay next illi working note torsbekagutte elli andre illi formula en irutthalva illi space ide ille melgade barkon bidi aitha tc is calculated how it is by using the formula tfc plus tvc alva so adereduna add madidivi one value substitute maadi torsidini next